What's good, everybody? It's your brother, Mad Black, the most dangerous and the most toxic black man on the internet. The brother who told you not to get that BBL, but you did it anyway, and now you're smelling weird. And I am black up in your face again with some more pro-black commentary. So it's come up over the last 2 weeks or so where there has been this trending topic on social media. And the trend actually says that BBLs smell. So there is this trend going on out there that says the BBL surgery, or just the women in general who have BBLs, smell weird or smell funky or whatever, right? And there have been people on social media telling their personal stories about this, like this one brother who gave this story about this woman he was dating smelling weird. There have been women who have had BBLs telling the story, saying that there was a weird smell. There have been women who, like, work in the nursing industry, or maybe they work in, like, some sort of, like, grooming, like, doing like, hair waxing and stuff like that, saying these types of women smell weird. So it's been a trending topic, and I want to talk a little bit about it here because I've spoken about these types of surgeries before and just how bad they are for your health and why most women really should avoid them. Okay, I understand they're popular, but not everything that's popular is right, and not everything right is popular. Okay, so let me talk about this, all right? Because the consensus is from a lot of these people who have given their little testimony about BBLs is that either the women who have BBLs are not used to having, you know, a big backside like that, so they don't understand how to clean it properly. So that's what the smell is coming from. But there's also the other side, and the other consensus is that what a lot of people don't understand about these types of surgeries is that they're pumping fat cells out of one part of your body and they're putting it into your backside. And sometimes, either after the surgery or even beyond that, some of that fat seeps out and some of that starts to, you know, come out of your pores. You start to have some sort of weird discharge in, you know, on your underwear or on your pants from these types of surgeries. A lot of people don't understand that or never heard of that. But that's what happens. I mean, that's like, I guess it's like a well-kept secret. But the only reason I know about it is because I watch and read a lot of medical digest. And like, I look at a lot of medical shows and stuff about stuff like this, where the women are going in after the fact to have this fixed. But, you know, a lot of people don't understand this because they just see, you know, the end result, or they see the nice made-up picture. So that's all they're concerned about, right? In my opinion, there's a third component to the reason where the smell is coming from it and it's not being addressed by these women. And the third component is the simps out there. And the reason I'm saying this is because, you know, there are some males out there who are attracted to these types of women, these sorts of fake plastic looking big butt women. And they're sleeping with these women, or they're having sex with them, or they're taking them out or giving them all this attention to have sex with them. And they're not bringing up the fact that these women stink or they smell bad, right? I remember it was a few years ago that, who was it? Nick Cannon, he brought up the fact that a lot of these women don't have good hygiene. And people were getting mad at him for saying this in a public forum, but he's right. And, you know, when he said, like, you know, these women, they'll be beautiful, but they don't have good hygiene down there. And when he says beautiful, he's talking about the Hollywood version of beautiful. Like, when he says these women are beautiful, he's talking about the Larsa Pippen, Kim Kardashian types. He's not talking about your everyday average beautiful woman. Okay, so don't, if you're a beautiful black woman, don't be offended by this, because I'm not talking about you if you're all natural. I'm talking about these plastic-looking females that you see on social media or in mainstream Hollywood. That's what he's talking about. And I don't really find those types of women attractive. I'm just being honest. I think, you know, women who have too much plastic surgery, like Kim Kardashian or Larsa Pippen, they look weird to me. They almost look alien, like they don't look human anymore, really. But that's the types of women he was talking about who don't have good hygiene because, one, like I said, it's these a lot of these surgeries, they're either pulling fat or they might even be putting some sort of like chemical in their body so that it's going to create some sort of weird smell. Or at the very least, if it's not a bad smell, it's going to be like a medical, something like you would smell in like a hospital or even in like a chemical factory, because some of that stuff does smell very much like artificial chemicals, and that's not pleasing to the nose or to your senses to smell that, right? So something like that might happen, or these women just have poor hygiene or don't know how to clean themselves properly, and you got these goofy simp Negroes who still want to sleep with them, right? There's still guys, because even the guy that brought up the whole BBL smells conversation on social media, even he said he made the girl go wash up and he still slept with her. So a lot of these men are still sleeping with these women, even though these women are funky. So that's part of the problem. And I know a lot of people don't want me to say this because they think, oh, you're just blaming the men. No, I'm not blaming the men because not all men are going to do this. So there are men out there who have sense and don't involve themselves with these types. Or at the very least have the common sense that if they are involved, if someone smells bad, they're not going to put their penis in them, right? So there's a difference. There's a lot of men out there who do have common sense. So what I'm talking about are these athletes or these stars in Hollywood or singers or people who work in music or whatever who have these huge egos and think that they're supposed to be with these plastic looking females and don't care what these women smell like, right? So they'll just go in or tell the woman to wash up or whatever and then think that it's all to the good, right? And, you know, there's some guys out there who think if they get enough money, they can be with these big BBL Instagram type models and it's still going to be all good because it doesn't matter what the woman smells like. I'm here to tell you that you might be causing some harm to yourself in that regard, okay? So be careful out there and understand that certain things that they can cause problems, like for the ladies out there, you don't need that stuff. Don't believe the hype of what Hollywood says or the hype of what social media says and making you think that you need to have your body altered in order to be attractive. That's not true. Okay, most normal men prefer a natural body anyway. And, you know, once again, I've told you about the really harsh repercussions. Like smelling bad is actually one of the repercussions that is not that bad. There's other things that can happen where you can get an infection or some sort of bacteria and you're in the hospital either about to die or they got to amputate something or cut something else off or whatever and you're looking worse than you ever thought you would, right? So there's so many risks with these types of surgeries and no one tells you, no one puts it out there. The doctor's not going to tell you because he just wants your money. But there are people out there dying from these types of surgeries and they don't tell you this. But the least of your worries or the lowest denominator of something bad that can happen to you is you smell bad. And at the very least, I know a lot of you don't want to be embarrassed by that. Just go ahead and have your natural body. Go do some squats. Go do some leg raises or whatever. You'll get the body you want. You don't need to do a lot of this surgery nonsense. Anyway, you folks let me know how you feel about it in the comments section. I'd very much like to hear your opinions on this. Anyway, Mad Black, and I will be back with my foot on a devil's back.